95% of serotonin is produced and stored in the gut, not the brain. Research has uncovered a connection between your gut bacteria and depression. In your lower intestine and colon, there is a garden of microscopic bacteria, fungi, and viruses. This collection of organisms is called the gut microbiome. Now, individually, they are minuscule, but collectively, they weigh about the same as your brain. And when fed the right food, they become an incredible pharmacy. They produce vital chemicals that are key to your immune system, and they produce neurotransmitters such as GABA and serotonin. GABA has a calming effect on the body and mind, and serotonin plays a crucial role in regulating mood, sleep, appetite, and pain sensitivity. Let's look at Emily. She has always been known for her cheerful and outgoing nature, but after a long course of antibiotics, she found herself plagued by a persistent feeling of sadness. Emily was eventually diagnosed with depression. Now, what is really interesting here is that she had a happy childhood, no traumas, a good relationship, and supportive friends. So the depression made no sense to her. But one day, she stumbled upon a fascinating article about the connection between the gut and mental health. She learned that antibiotics actually kill off the good gut bacteria, and this can cause depression. So, doing some further research, Emily decided to take charge of her gut health and started to incorporate probiotic-rich foods such as live natural yogurt, sauerkraut, and kimchi into her diet. These foods contain live bacteria that helped populate her gut with beneficial microbes. And to further support her gut health, she minimised processed foods and refined sugars, which are known to kill off the good bacteria. So as time passed, Emily noticed subtle changes. She began to experience improved digestion, increased energy levels, and a more stable mood. Her depression started to lift and she felt more resilient and better equipped to handle life's challenges. Now, as a psychotherapist, I'm more than aware that treating depression isn't always as simple as changing your diet. Depression is a complex and chronic mood disorder that's influenced by many factors, including genetics, environment, and your history. But what I'm trying to illustrate is that a vast amount of research has shown a definite link between your gut microbiome and your mental health. For example, scientists transplanted poo from depressed mice into sterile mice. Now, the sterile mice had no gut microbes, but once the poo transplant had taken place, the previously sterile mice demonstrated behavioural and physiological features characteristic of depression. Researchers are now experimenting with faecal microbiota transplants in humans, and this has shown improvements in bipolar disorder, depression, insulin sensitivity, Crohn's disease, as well as reductions in anxiety and ADHD symptoms. So you can see that researchers are moving towards the development of microbiota-based interventions in the treatment of depression. For example, there are now a lot of studies that illustrate how probiotics reduce depression and anxiety symptoms. Now, researchers are calling these probiotics psychobiotics, and the main constituent of these psychobiotics is the bifidobacterium and lactobacilli families. So fermented foods that contain lactic acid, such as cultured milk and yogurt products, sauerkraut and sourdough bread, have been found to increase levels of the bifidobacteria and lactobacilli families. I think it's really empowering that you can increase serotonin by the food you eat. And this really conflicts with the notion that you need antidepressants because you have a chemical imbalance in your brain. Remember, 95% of serotonin is actually produced and stored in the gut, not the brain. The Council for Evidence-Based Psychiatry says, although scientists have been testing the chemical imbalance theory's validity for over 40 years, and despite literally thousands of studies, there is still not one piece of direct evidence proving the theory correct. The chemical imbalance theory originally came from pharmaceutical companies as a way of marketing their antidepressants. And if you think about it, there is not and never has been a test to measure your brain chemicals. You cannot measure neurotransmitters via a blood test, MRI scan, or a CT scan. I'm not saying don't use antidepressants, but I do believe that rather than relying so heavily on antidepressants, we do need to address the root cause of depression via psychological therapy and increase the growth and diversity of your gut microbiota. So your gut talks to your brain and your brain talks to your gut. The communication is bi-directional. Your gut and brain send messages via your vagus nerve. So your vagus nerve connects the gut and brain through what is called the gut-brain axis, all of which play a vital role in sleep, pain, mood, hunger, and stress. It communicates information from the gut to your brain using neurotransmitters such as serotonin and glutamate and gut hormones. Suddenly, the idea of having a gut instinct makes sense. So if you ever notice how language is rich with gut-based expressions, if you ever had a gut-wrenching experience or butterflies in your stomach. Your emotions, brain and gut are intricately connected. In fact, your gut is frequently called your second brain. It even has its own nervous system, the enteric nervous system. The enteric nervous system is embedded in the lining of your gastrointestinal tract, beginning in your esophagus and extending down to your anus. It consists of more than 500 million neurons. So scientists are now recognising the importance of a healthy and diverse gut microbiome in the role of good mental health. So are you going to make some changes to your diet to improve the growth and diversity of your microbiome? Let me know in the comments. And if you've enjoyed this video, you may be interested in the video on the screen now. And I look forward to seeing you soon.